Hey everybody, Elliot here with Lazy Dogs Records, and here's a contest entry for you. Rachel at Music Ma'am has a contest. She's got about 88 subscribers now. She's trying to push up to 100 and beyond subscribers. So her contest is called Gender Bender, and she wants us to cite albums or artists or lyrics that address the subject of gender. And so I had to think on this for a long time, and I think I've come up with a few things. Don't have all the actual albums that will work with it, but here we go. Anyway, first thing I think of, when I was about 10 or 11 years old, we bought a 45 from the man in black, Mr. Johnny Cash. And it was the big hit of that year, A Boy Named Sue. And of course, I guess this is a naming gender bend here. The Shel Silverstein penned song about the boy that grew up with a girl's name and finally found his father, who had abandoned them many years before, and had it out with him. And, you know, that was just kind of a lighthearted look at kind of creating some gender confusion there. Okay, my second one is obvious. I just listened to this album yesterday, I believe. It's Hunky Dory David Bowie. And David Bowie was the very androgynist, I guess would be the term. Really, you know, he could come across as very feminine or very macho, dressing as a woman sometimes, I guess, that sort of thing. And I was just totally confused by David Bowie when it came out. I didn't know how to take him. One quick little story. I've always got a little story. I have a cousin who lived overseas growing up. Her father was worked for a British oil company, and so they were in different parts of the world, and they were in Africa when she got out of elementary school, and so they sent her to England, to boarding school, for high school period. And sometime along, either in high school or right out of high school or something, she made friends. I don't know how much, you know, how much friends, and just maybe a casual friendship or exactly or what, but with David Bowie's girlfriend or wife or something. And I remember her telling me, yes, she was over at their house, and Bowie records were, you know, in boxes stacked around the house, and they were hanging out, and Bowie comes in. And he was, I think, the way she put it, none too pleased that there was anybody else at the house at the time when she was there. So it's not like she suddenly became a big David Bowie friend or anything. I think he was annoyed that she was even there. And then the next one totally gave me the, what? I don't have the actual, I got a bunch of Kinks albums, but I don't have the one that has Lola on it. But I'm shocked that was a big album-oriented rock radio hit. Played it all the time, and I'm going, wait, what? Huh? She took up there. I mean, he boys will be girls, and girls will be, whoa. I didn't know what to think of that one. But I'm really shocked that there wasn't some censor effort over that song. Maybe there was, but they just ignored it or whatever. But really, the story of a transvestite that takes the innocent guy upstairs, and he doesn't know, you know, what the heck is going on. And let's see, the fourth one I'll cite. I don't have any music by this person, but his name was Billy Tipton, and he was a jazz pianist and a a talent broker. I think he booked acts and things like that up in the Northwest, mostly originally from Oklahoma. And Billy Tipton was born a female. And at first, I think to fit into and get work and things like that, she started binding her breasts and presenting herself as Billy, a male, and getting a lot of work, you know, as a male pianist in jazz, and eventually transitioning completely to identifying as a male. So much so, Billy was married or had live-in girlfriends, five different ones, long-term relationships, I guess you'd say, with five different women. The first one was a lesbian relationship in the 1930s. But by 1940, he was presenting himself both privately and professionally as a male. And the next four wives really did not realize that he was actually born a female. And in fact, I think he explained to them that he had been in a bad accident and been injured severely. And that was it. And when he passed away in his 70s, I think, most of his family and most of his colleagues still live in that. The people that knew him in the 1930s, you know, knew this, but most of them were probably gone at this point. It was a surprise when they realized that Billy was actually physically a female. So that's Billy Tipton, jazz. He had a jazz trio that played, I think Spokane, Washington was where it's based out of, and he also, like I said, was a music booker. And my last one, this may or may not be, but I've always had the feeling. Go back, Shel Silverstein wrote A Boy Named Sue. Well, he wrote a bunch of songs. He also wrote one called The Queen of the Silver Dollar, and a bunch of people recorded that song. The original recording was by Dr. Hook. Shel Silverstein wrote a bunch of Dr. Hook songs. Sylvia's Mother, cover of the Rolling Stone. And then several different acts recorded Queen of the Silver Dollar. Dave and Sugar, the country pop act, did it. In 1975 or so, Emmylou Harris did it. And when I listen to that song, I just have the feeling that the Queen of the Silver Dollar was drag queen. I've looked at the lyrics, and it doesn't reveal itself that way in the lyrics. But I've just always gotten that vibe from the song. It's just, you know, I don't know. Anyway, Rachel, good luck. Hope you get to 100 and beyond subscribers real soon. Enjoyed doing this one. I had to really think hard to come up, figure this one out. But there's my entry into the Gender Bender contest. And if you're not subscribing to Rachel's channel, I'll put it at the bottom here. Please do. She's got a lot of interesting musical offerings in her videos. I think you'll enjoy that. And I also have a contest up myself that's going on for several more weeks. And I'll put that link at the end of this video, I guess. If you get a chance, enter my contest, enter Rachel's contest, and we'll talk to you later. Remember, be kind to your neighbors, and everybody is your neighbor.